But it is good to be here. This building itself is a landmark to engineering. Built by the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, 16 months during a world war. 16 months? We can't pull permits in 16 months. That's amazing. So whether we're talking about the Pentagon, you know, it's a great place for us to do this because our nation has historically associated engineers with its military. You know, the first military school was the U.S. Military Academy at West Point. In fact, that was the only engineer school for a long time. And our nation looked to our military for its engineer expertise. And it wasn't until after the land-grant program, after the Civil War, that states started developing engineering schools. It was always the military that was the go-to. So again, being in the Pentagon is the right place to have this discussion. You, as military engineers, are really a cornerstone of what we've done with this nation. You know, whether we're talking about the Pentagon or the Panama Canal or the Lincoln Memorial or the Washington Monument or the Everglades projects, you know, environmental restoration in the Great Lakes, the nation consistently turns to the military to provide engineering expertise. And so it's an honor to be here on the stage sharing this profession with you. And I think that's one of the critical elements. It's certainly one that we try and instill in all of our young engineers. This is a profession. And you must feel that way as well, because this isn't a job to you, or you wouldn't be sitting here dialing in. This is a profession. You have been called a higher calling to combine technology and science and develop amazing outcomes. That's more than a job. And I'm happy to be here sharing this profession with you. You know, when I was in college, back when dinosaurs did roam the earth, right, I worked for the dean of our engineering school for a while. And as you can imagine, he was a little passionate about the role of engineers and engineer education. Amazing man, part of the greatest generation, flew bombers in World War II, Dr. Buckley. And so one day I made the mistake of telling Dr. Buckley, after graduation, I think I'm going to go to law school. I think it'd be great to combine those two fields, civil engineering, the law, be a technical attorney, and he blew his mind. I don't think he realized that we had actually signed the peace agreement with Japan, because he said, "Heitkamp, the Japanese are eating our lunch. This is why they're getting ahead. They've got 20 engineers for every lawyer. We got less than 3 engineers for every lawyer." And so needless to say, I did not get to go to law school. And ended up going, he said, "What we really need is water security. That's what our world needs, is water security. You're going to school for water treatment, and you're not going to start filing lawsuits." And you know, although it's over 30 years since we had that conversation, it's as true today as it was then. We need engineers more than ever. I know we need them in the Corps of Engineers. As Paul mentioned, we were just commissioned by the administration to fix the nation's infrastructure, to repair, replace, improve infrastructure that has been aging for a long time. And so the administration made this huge investment, almost $100 billion, to start this work. And this is like the worst day at Ranger School. What are you going to do now, Ranger? Right? You got the money you asked for. Now you need to put these projects in the ground. Now you need to make this steel and concrete appear and improve what we have for the American people, not for today, but for the next 100 years. This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, but it's a huge challenge. So our biggest opportunity is also our biggest challenge. But to make that worse, if that was possible, we have to do it during a time of climate change. So we have an existential threat with climate change. And we can't just go into the old tool bag and use the old solutions that worked before. But my boss calls it new old. So you might get it new, but it's old technology, it's old thinking. We can't do new old. We need new. We need new solutions for these problems. New, got it, yeah, new. Well, that briefs well, right? That's really hard to do. So we've done things like really ramping up our R&D investments. But it's also mentally getting people to think about change. And so, you know, I think General Shinseki said it best. Anybody old enough here to be in the blue bedroom at CGSC at Leavenworth? I know there's some online. There I was as a major sitting listening to General Shinseki, and he was talking about transformation. And really his whole point was, you have to be a transformational leader. You have to be able to be flexible and agile. And he said, you know, I know a lot of you don't like change, but you're going to like being irrelevant a whole lot less. And it's always stuck with me, because those are well-put words for the mission that the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers has. And we're driving change every day. I'm going to give you three quick examples. One of our most promising project is called Engineering with Nature. So instead of building higher seawalls or more concrete and steel, this is using the natural engineering processes to ensure that we have better security with environmental, economic, and social benefits. We're also doing something with smart buildings. So we're incorporating passive technology into our smart buildings, all of our new construction, to try and reduce the amount of fossil fuels that are consumed in those facilities. So much like Paul was describing, a few small changes can really make amazing returns. And then the last one is, it's for those of you who know dredging, that's basically lowering harbors and rivers and ports so that it can support larger ships. Well, there's not much older technology than dredging, right? We've been doing that since the 1800s. So don't tell me this is new. But we're using artificial intelligence to help us optimize that dredging, which is really amazing, because it's allowing us to maximize commerce to such a better level, places that we weren't able to operate in before. So how we deliver this within the Corps of Engineers are multiple discipline teams, delivery teams, coming from a whole host of backgrounds. And you know, it seems like our boundaries are blurring. So when we graduated engineering school, you worked either in mechanical engineering or electrical engineering or civil engineering. Those boundaries were very, very distinct. Not anymore, they're blurred. And it's not enough to be a good engineer. It's not enough to be a good technical expert. We also need you to use the other side of your brain. I need you to be able to lead and motivate teams. I need you to get them excited to work together. You know, there's nothing worse than a whole room full of introverted engineers, right? Trying to get them to talk and work and collaborate together. Oh, yeah, that's what we need our engineers to do. And so, you know, we tried to incorporate that in how we develop our engineers, but that's really tough. How do you encourage creativity? How do you teach creativity? How do you teach engineers to tell a good story? Right? Did I lose you? You're probably like, why do I need to tell a good story? Well, do you like funding? Because that's how you're going to get it. This great idea you've got, this new innovation, you're going to have to tell a compelling story for somebody to believe in you and take a chance on this new idea. And given the price tag of some of our projects, that had better be a fascinating story, right? So we need engineers who think differently than we did when we were going through school. But that's what we're growing every day at the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers. We are inspiring our engineers to do more, to aspire to greatness. And we have a big tent, right? You don't have to be a licensed engineer to have a role in what we're doing. You know, in Disney, they call them Imagineers. That's the members of their teams. Well, in USACE, we have Solutioneers. And they come from every walk of life, every background, every degree, every discipline. And you would be amazed what that diversity of thought can produce when they all work together. I mean, one of my best Solutioneers majored in hospitality management. And this woman can do anything. She's amazing. She's one of our best program managers. So I don't look down my nose just because you didn't go to an 8-bed accredited program. There is plenty of room in the circle of love for everybody to help. And we're bringing them all into USACE. But don't take it from me. I want you to take it from the men and women who actually work there. So go ahead and roll the tape, please.
One of the things that I really enjoy about working here at the Corps of Engineers is that we work at just an incredible scale. Usually the problems that we get asked to solve are problems that either the local or the state government couldn't solve or didn't have the finances to solve. And so we get engaged because these issues, these concerns are at a national scale or they're at just a massive scale.
Depending on what you do, the Corps will have something for you to do. The mission is always evolving. There's always new things, great innovation, great people to work for. The leadership for myself, I've had a great experience in all the missions I've been on, Puerto Rico, Afghanistan, Iraq, and as well as here in Kuwait. So I don't think you would ever make a bad choice by choosing the Corps of Engineers.
And one of the reasons I started working for the Corps was I saw that they had a very detailed and systematic way of how they managed to control the quality of the projects that we deliver.
We do so many different things that, I've learned to do things I've never done before, like I said, just from, you know, job to job, it's always different.
Even though I've only been with these days for a little over 2 years, I've been a government employee for over 20, and of all the different agencies I've worked for, this is the place that feels like home, and this has been the place that I've loved the most.
Lots of potential and opportunity, lots of upward mobility, promotional opportunities. I think USACE offers outside of the box type of scenarios.
So if you want to travel and see a lot of things and you want to do a lot of things that are challenging and exciting, but you don't want to have to join the military in order to do so, this is the organization to be in.
Don't be afraid of the title. The U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, there's no requirement to enlist and you don't have to be an engineer.
And it really resonated with me, USACE's mission to provide and to protect for our country and our environment. And I believe what USACE does for our wetlands and all of the waters of the United States is invaluable, and I just really wanted to be a part of that team.
Well, I think the number one aspect working with USACE is working in teams. We have such strong teams that have deep technical competencies. We also are a global organization, and so we have teams that are from all walks of life.
I like working with the people. I like the challenge of the projects. And I like the camaraderie that is part of an organization that helps to serve the people of the United States and federal government. It's something I'm very proud of. And I love coming to work every day just because of it.
Corps of Engineers is structured with an overall different diversity of all professionals. And it's a very professional place to work.
It has to be the people. We have an amazingly good group of people working here in the Corps. You find they show up with every kind of background, every kind of experience base, every kind of academic credentials.
If you're interested in practical work, in engaging stakeholders, and working, you know, getting your hands real dirty with big problems that matter to the nation, come to the Corps.
If you're a young engineer looking for a career, I would highly recommend the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers. If you're looking to advance your career, please look to us. We have a variety of engineering disciplines and positions within the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers to help you take your career to new heights.
I really enjoy what we do for the local communities and for the public, as well as for the military.
It's the best experience you could imagine throughout a career. You can go anywhere in the world pretty much you can do any job that you want without ever having to change the organization you're with, and most importantly, your retirement plan.
I love the people I work with. The work culture here is very respectful, and everyone I work with is great at what they do. And most importantly, as a computer scientist, this is very important to me. Everyone here is always looking for the most innovative technological solutions, which makes my job very rewarding.
I love everything, but the sheer amount and variety of opportunities that I get, USACE has allowed me to travel the world.
What I enjoy most about my job is a variety of different work that we get to do on a daily basis.
The organization is going to offer you incredible benefits, and it's also going to offer you incredible opportunities to give back.